Weather.
Okay, we've been watching this thunderstorm going just outside of Pocatello, coming in from the northwest, getting into Bingham County, and it's actually a pretty mean-looking thunderstorm. In fact, the National Weather Service just a bit ago has now issued a severe thunderstorm warning. This is going to go until 6:15, and this is for areas near Rockford and Blackfoot, and we're seeing the possibility of 60 mile per hour wind gusts, and also hailstones out of this thundercloud as it's coming in here from the northwest to the southeast. Now, things are drying up in southeastern Idaho. We've had some thunderstorms also in areas just outside of Salmon, and we're working on this thunderstorm, and again, that severe thunderstorm warning now for areas outside of Blackfoot and getting into areas of Fort Hall. And again, this is a severe thunderstorm warning until 6 o'clock, 6:15 here. In fact, I'm going to switch to another Viper view real quick, just because, again, this warning just coming in. So excuse my movement of the radar right now. So the thunderstorm right now is just getting into Rockford. It's going to be the core of that thunderstorm. I mean, it's already getting into Rockford, but the core of that thunderstorm is looking at Rockford at 6:07 p.m. here. And again, a severe thunderstorm warning. The polygon extends from just down the outskirts of Wapello to Blackfoot proper to north of Fort Hall, and including the town of Pingree there. So from Pingree to Rockford to Blackfoot and all points in between there out towards Moreland, we have a severe thunderstorm warning until 6:15 here. And this is a very strong cell that's coming into Bingham County right now, moving to the east. So we'll have more on that as it develops, and I'll get some more information for you maybe later in this newscast. But outside, yeah, it's a hot one, and we're seeing very toasty temperatures thanks to high pressure building in here, and more thunderstorms coming along for the ride. High pressure currently over areas of the Four Corners, and this thunderstorm activity stretching from Idaho all the way into the Dakotas and even right along the Front Range of the Rockies. We will continue to strengthen this ridge of high pressure over the next couple of days, and we also have a slight chance of thunderstorms. Here's the good news, though. As we move through tonight and tomorrow, we dry things out just a little bit. We will still have a few thunderstorms out there, but they're not going to be as prevalent. We will see just a few isolated cells in here for Tuesday evening right around 6-7 o'clock with some partly mostly cloudy skies, and the same for Wednesday with some cloud cover building in throughout the day on Wednesday. A couple isolated cells out there, but nothing too major for the Wednesday thunderstorm threat. The big story here is really the heat. It's going to really warm up on Wednesday with the strengthening ridge of high pressure over the Four Corners, and then it's going to move into southern Nevada. Then you have a low that's kind of going just around that high, heading to the north of us. As it does so, it's going to drive in gusty winds and a lot of hot air being blown in from the south. So Wednesday is looking to be the hottest day of the week, and then we're pulling in some gusty conditions Wednesday and Thursday. There is the heat advisory for the heat on Wednesday with highs into the upper 90s in areas of the plain, and then we have a heat warning for areas of the Magic Valley out through Boise. Highs around 96 for Malad, 90 in Soda Springs, and 94 in Preston tomorrow, with highs in Jackson at 86, 92 for Rexburg, and 85 in Island Park. Highs in central Idaho in the upper 90s for Salmon and Chouse, lower 90s in Stanley, and highs in the Snake River Plain at 93 for Idaho Falls, 94 for Blackfoot and Pocatello, 97 in Burley. And as we go into the Blackfoot 8-day forecast, we'll see highs here in the mid to upper 90s, gusty winds in the forecast for Wednesday and Thursday. Temperatures, though, taking a hit as we get into Thursday and Friday. That low's passing through northern Idaho and Montana. That's going to lower our temperatures just a bit for a couple days, and then we're going to quickly rebound that heat back into the 90s for the weekend. Rexburg, 94 for tomorrow, 96 for Wednesday. It's going to be very hot in Rexburg also for Wednesday afternoon. Then we'll see the temperatures come down just a little bit into the 80s for Friday, back low to mid 90s for Saturday and Sunday. Salmon, we're going to be pushing the upper 90s on Wednesday, 91 on Thursday, and again for Friday, with temperatures very close to 100 this weekend there for Lemhi County for Saturday and Sunday. Jackson, highs around 90 for Wednesday, mid 80s for Thursday, and bringing in mostly sunny conditions for this weekend with highs into the 80s and 90s. It's going to be very hot this weekend in Jackson and far eastern Idaho. Here's your Pocatello 8-day forecast. A couple thunderstorms out there tonight. We'll have a slight chance of a thunderstorms in there for Tuesday and Wednesday, but you're dealing mainly with the heat, with highs around 98 degrees on Wednesday, 93 for Thursday, down to the lower 90s on Thursday, the upper 80s on Friday. And Idaho Falls, we're going to see the mid to upper 90s in there for Wednesday. We'll call about 95 for Wednesday, and down to about the mid 80s for Friday, with the low mid 90s for Saturday and Sunday with sunshine, and carrying the heat for next week as well. Our John Adams GMC Spirit of Idaho come to us from Melody in Idaho Falls. Got a beautiful picture of the fireworks the other night. I believe this was taken on Saturday, and just a great 4th of July. course, it was a hot 4th of July with a couple thunderstorms out there for good measure. But I'd like to see your photos. Go to news3now.com. You go to our website. You go to the weather section, and under the weather section, you'll see a webpage called Spirit of Idaho. And that's where you can upload the photos, too, to get them on TV. Guys, brace for the heat. More on the way.
All right. All right. Thank you so much, Michael. Well, that's how our weather's doing. How's our sports?
Well, we're making some fireworks in sports tonight. Coming up, the Chuckers are looking to get back in the win column.